Let's talk a little high school football here. If you go by the score of their games, the West Forsyth Titans are 2-1. But because their week one opponent had an ineligible player dressed for the game, they're actually 3-0. Taking that perfect record to visit the 2-1 East Forsyth Eagles. We pick it up. Titans ball trailing 28-17, but not for long. Bobby Clark here with a 5-yard touchdown scamper. That would make it 28-23, and that little girl is excited. You know it by looking at her. Later, West Chris Neese recovers the fumble, but Eastwood survive that possession. Much to the chagrin of those fans, they would not survive this possession, though. Bradley Rooney to Ricky Brown, 55 yards, and it's a thing of beauty for the boys from Clemens. They take the lead, and they hold on to the lead. West drops 37 points on East and improves to 4-0. 37-28 is your final. Staying at Cartersville, Glenn looking for its first win of the season, hosting Mount Tabor early on. Things not looking good for the Bobcats. Blair Stokes makes Tabor fans stoked here after this 68-yard touchdown run. Wish I had him on my fantasy team this weekend. Tabor up 6-0, but Glenn would block the extra point, which is why it is 6-0. That's exactly the way Coach drew it up. Chris Sims, way to get a piece of the ball right there. That is big. Later, it is Mr. Stokes again from a much shorter distance. Still counts the same, though. And Tabor's two-point conversion would be good. Trust me. Spartans top 40 points for the third week in a row. 43-9 is your final. Parkland visiting Atkins. Both teams off to slow starts this season. Early on, though, the Mustangs looking awfully good. First possession, Chris Hairston takes the handoff, jukes past the defender, and is in for the 32-yard score. It's 7-0 Parkland. The Dancers absolutely love it. They also love this. Quarterback Carlos, don't call me David Gregory. He beats the press. He beats the press, and he beats every Atkins defender to the end zone. That would make it 14-0. And that would be your knockout blow early on. Atkins falls to 0-3. Parkland improves to 500. 46-14 is your final. R.J. Reynolds hosting Carver in a 4A Central Piedmont battle. Yellow Jackets quarterback Madison Mills, he of the two last name, finds Denzel Rice from 20 yards out. It wouldn't be a Friday night show if we didn't have a Denzel touchdown, right? Guys on every week. 6-0 Carver. Later, it's Mills again. After we take a look at the cheerleaders. And who do you think he's looking for? Yeah. It's Denzel again, and yeah, it's another touchdown. Later, Reynolds would answer Vance Matthews here. We'll find Andy Teasdall deep in the end zone. No tease here. He would score. That would make it 12-7. Carter, though, goes on to win. 39-14 is your final. Next, it's the Battle of Yadkin County, the Unify Bowl. Forbush visiting Starmount. Rams quarterback Jake Barr airs it out to Tanner Vestal. And that's one of the best plays we'll see all night. That may be one of my worst ones yet. 75 yards for the touchdown. That, friends, is one big Ram. Jake plays a little defense, too. A super pick here off of an errant Falcon pass. Second week in a row, Jake has had a leaping grab in the secondary. And on the very next play, Jake decides to stay on the field, and he decides to give the ball to his big running back. That is MJ Bryant. That makes it 21-3. Starmount keeps on rolling. 44-3 is your final over Forbush. Staying in the Mountain Valley, East Wilkes visiting Elkin. The Mini Elks did not stay at a Holiday Inn Express last night. They stayed at the YMCA. We pick it up second half. East quarterback Stephen Gregory tries the long ball, but Elkin's Donovan Smith has other ideas. East Wilkes D would respond, though. Clint Garris is going to sack Elkin's quarterback Ethan Creed. And he will do so with arms wide open if you know your late 90s run. Not much scoring here, but just enough for the Bucking Elks. They take it 21-0. After the